Well, when COVID-19 hit Montana in March, live music venues were the first to shut down and likely will be the last to fully reopen. The financial fallout has crushed both venue owners and the artists they book. Without stages put play on, the local musicians have had to adapt, find new ways to stay in front of their audience and earn a living. Tonight, Q2's Paul Humphrey checks in with a popular Montana duo to find out how they managed to record, promote, and release their new album.
That fear, that anxiety of what's next all around a microbe. But when you have a fear about your economic living being blasted, wow.
For musicians Josh Keir and John McClellan, the pandemic year of 2020 has been one of a different rhythm.
Originally, there was, you know, kind of a little bit of a panic mode that set in and things.
The plan for this year was to release their new studio album, Ghosts Go West, by early this summer.
It was pretty arbitrary thinking back about it now, but in our minds, and at least in mine for sure, and I was kind of pressing him that we wanted this out like July 1st.
But then the pandemic hit and the music stopped. But the shutdown wasn't all bad.
COVID actually helped us, right? So it gave us more time. It gave us more time to go through the songs.
It was really cool to be able to step back and go, dude, let's just take our time. No one's pressuring us. It's just this internal pressure that we're men, we work hard, we take care of things. No, you're not, dude. You're human. You got to step back and rest like everybody else.
The project is definitely better because of the more time that we got because of this.
Extra time in the studio was great, but
anybody who knows El Wencho knows that we want to play live, period. We need people.
Facebook garage gigs complete with a virtual tip jar got the band's music to their fans.
The first time we set up and played, it was the two of us in his garage. We played a piece of sheetrock on the wall. We were sweating. We were like so into it. We didn't care if there was three people watching us. It was the most bizarre thing. And we'd get done. We did like six songs in a row, like a normal, complete El Wencho show. And we got done and we were just like sweating and there's just silence. And I was like, this is so bizarre, but it was so fun.
Craft Local Billings, this one's for them.
Wanting to give back, the band split their virtual tip jar with the venues they would have been playing. That fast-tracked the band's community initiative. And now,
we're going to take a percentage of our net every show, merch sales, whatever it is, and we're going to put that aside. And what we want to do is do, I don't know the exact money amount it's going to be, but we're going to do a yearly scholarship.
Two Montana music makers with a message of unity, setting the tone to survive the pandemic. Proving that when the tone is right, the tune is good. In Billings, Paul Humphrey, MTN News.
Nice. All right. Thanks so much, Paul. Well, when the Big Sky State fully reopens, the band hopes to play a full slate of spring and summer shows.